Czyli słuchając ciebie, Januszu, można dojść do wniosku, że poczysty...
So listening to you, Janusz, one might reach the conclusion that for pure impressionism, one must go back to the Seine, because in its homeland, impressionism can be found in its purest form. Although, ever there, you can find artists whose work is included in the Impressionism category by some, and not by others. One such artist who we mentioned in previous episodes is the esteemed Edgar Degas. A well-known figure, his paintings are reproduced in numerous albums, and yet not every one of his paintings could be called Impressionist. Some say there are elements of post-Impressionism. Others see traces of academicism or realism. At any rate, he's a French artist raised in France, though he spent some time doing his work in the USA. What would you say about him?
Co byś o nim ciekawego powiedział?
Na pewno jest to malarz właśnie, który bardziej przypomina tych polskich reprezentantów impresjonizmu, czyli artysta, który wytwarza bardzo osobliwą, osobistą redakcję tego nurtu. Niewątpliwie jego wczesna twórczość jest mocno osadzona w akademizmie, ale już takim przetworzonym.
He's definitely an artist whose work is more similar to Polish versions of impressionism. An artist who creates more peculiar and personal forms of this trend. His earlier work is firmly set in academicism, but in a processed and rewritten form by Thomas Degas creates a painting that, with their subject matter and scale and typology of performance, could be described as an academic, but in terms of workshop, they don't have the characteristic finishing touches known in academicism. They are painted in a more hidden and direct way, like in the case of Thomas. These are his early works, but his very original artist went through various stages of creativity.
Ściśle impresjonistyczne, nie może tak modelowe jak Pissarra czy Claude Monet, ale jednak takie, które możemy śmiało przypisać temu rdzeniowi impresjonizmu.
There are some strictly impressionistic works, perhaps not as model as his or Claude Monet, but ones that can still be included in the core of impressionist style. His later works certainly belong to the new period, but Degas does belong to a line of specific original artists. When it comes to impressionists, Paul Cézanne is particularly interesting, an artist who generationally was older than he and Claude Monet, but did follow the impressionist trend to its core. His approach to painting one theme was like Monet's, whose approach to painting one motive allowed him to convey information about a certain respect, about the sensibility of our cognitive experience and the sensual nature of reality. This reality, in an essential sense, might not be knowable.
O zmysłowości naszego doświadczenia poznawczego i zmysłowym charakterze rzeczywistości, o tym, że ta rzeczywistość w takim sensie esencjalnym.
In the case of Cézanne, his pieces also seek out one solid motive from which he conveys his artistic content. It turns out that Cézanne places less importance on artistically and ideologically accentuating the sensuality and the volatility of the piece, and more on what the basis of the construction principles of the visual reality are, the perceived reality. His art takes him to an interesting conclusion, that visual reality can be depicted in several geometric shapes.
Zasad konstrukcji rzeczywistości wizualnej. Nie rzeczywistości jako takiej, ale tej postrzeganej. Jego praktyka malarska doprowadza go do ciekawych konkluzji formalnych, zwłaszcza wówczas, kiedy opisuje rzeczywistość wizualną jako właściwie taką, którą możemy zredukować do kilku brył geometrycznych.
So what you're saying seems to pave the way for cubism.
Oczywiście i przede wszystkim też
of course, and also post-impressionism, all these trends that have moved on from looking at painting from the perspective of recording something in the sensual and chromatic sense.
Sensualnego, zmysłowego, chromatycznego.
Januszu, wymieniamy tutaj nazwiska różnych ludzi i jesteśmy w położeniu daleko lepszym.
Naming and talking about these artists is much easier than for those historians looking at art from medieval times, when artists tended to be anonymous. Not much can be said about them. The names of those who created great works of those times are often unknown. As time goes on, more artists begin to appear out of the shadows, and the biographies of creators of Impressionism, Post-Impressionism, and other forms of art after that are often known in great detail. Do you ever think about the relationship between the various experiences, the thoughts, the tragedies of an artist's life, and the effect it had on what they painted and how they painted it? Now, returning to Degas, who is, of course, an exceptional artist, whose fascination with ballet dancers is well known. In fact, we see this theme in many of his paintings. It is true what is said about him, that this fascination with dancing figures, with ballerinas, with young girls taking dancing lessons, was a result of his own illness, which made actual moving around difficult for him. He had some problem with his legs and was not only unable to dance, but had a hard time just getting around. Painting these moving figures, these dancers, was an escape for him, because in this way he experienced something that he could not fulfill in his own life.
W ten sposób realizował to, czego nie mógł doświadczyć we własnym życiu.
Myślę, że takie spojrzenie na jego sztukę może być zaakceptowane.
This view of his art is acceptable, but first and foremost, without a doubt, the main thing that, in the most expressive and artistically important way, defined his art was the problem of movement. This isn't just about dancers. He first tackled the problem of movement by showcasing racehorses.
Zwróćmy uwagę, że on najpierw problem ruchu starał się zgłębić poprzez przedstawianie wyścigów konnych, czyli poprzez przedstawianie takich scen, takich sytuacji.
He depicted scenes and situations that involve movement which can be deeply analyzed and disclosed. In this sense, the psychological aspect had its meaning. Movement becomes more important to him than the Impressionist fundament of the vibration of the light. This wasn't as deeply embedded as movement.
Na przykład niż sama tkanka malarska typowo impresjonistyczna, bazująca na rozedrganiu światła, to nie tak go głęboko nie zajmowało właśnie jak ruch. Wybrał sobie problem, który być może właśnie w ten sposób był dla niego istotny, ale myślę, że jeszcze chwilę poświęcimy mu czasu.
He picked a problem that was important to him, but we can talk about him a bit more in the following episode to explain how this built a foundation for new art exhibitions. You touched on an interesting point, mentioning that more is known about these artists. Yes, of course, this era is closer, and this is natural, but what is important and inspiring in this context, because the technique of painting changes in such a revolutionary way, is that it turns out, in time, that each of the artists applies their paint in a different way. The emotion that is there while painting the canvas becomes an important trademark of the artist.
Farby, ten element emocji przy pokrywaniu farbą płótna zaczyna stanowić istotne znamie artysty.
Even without a signature at the bottom of the painting, we can still find out who painted it.
Dostrzegają tą swoistość i szybko nadają jej szczególnych cech. To powoduje głęboką dynamikę rozwoju.
Artists quickly recognize specificity and quickly give it specific features. This causes the profound dynamics of painting to develop, the development of the medium of expression, and in this way, through their creativity, artists become more expressive, one of a kind, as opposed to those who create in the canon of academicism. Here, the differences are more subtle and more difficult to notice, at least by an onlooker without artistic experience.
Artystycznymi malarskimi działaniami.
Przygotowałeś nas po części.
Thank you, Janusz. You have prepared the audience for the eras that in actual fact are already underway during Impressionism, and this will need to be covered. And we should refer to the aforementioned artists in upcoming episodes. And we invite the audience to Stay with us for that. This episode was filmed thanks to the Kamenica Theater in Warsaw. We appreciate their courtesy and their help. Goodbye for now from Marcin Bosch. See you next time.
W Warszawie. Żegnamy się z Państwem. Marcin Bosch
i Janusz Janowski.